And welcome back to Sex Tales. I am your host, Julius Caesar, alongside the lovely Mr. Chad Bailey.
Hey, what's up?
And my co-host and best friend, Loso, you already know so. And we got our special guest, Mr. Trent Cruz, in the building.
What's up?
Thank you guys for joining and our special Valentine's Day Sex Tales episode.
We love being interactive with our viewers. Let's keep in touch. Like our IG and Facebook at Sex Tales TV Show for exclusive extras, sexy photos from the cast, and more.
It is that time of year where love is celebrated for everyone. Yes, it's Valentine's Day. With today's show, we will discuss the good, the bad, the downright ugly on such an evil holiday. What the fuck is that?
Well, let's get it started, guys. Let's play this amazing game called the Coochie Box.
Ooh, the Coochie Box.
We will each pull out and not nut. I don't know how to not do that. And we'll answer what it says inside.
Well, I don't eat pussy, so I don't know.
I know, it should have been called the Boochie Box.
Yeah,
or the Cootie Box.
The Boochie, what the fuck? I've never heard that one before, okay.
That's new for 2020.
Okay, the Boochie Box.
The Boochie Box.
I can't.
Take away from
I'm
it,
first?
Though.
I'm nervous because it's just always some bullshit.
All right, so let Trent go first. Go ahead and do it first.
Oh, let me take one now.
Take one.
I know what's going to be like.
All right, Trent, you go first.
I got to go first? All right, hold on.
How many dicks have you sucked behind the scenes?
Do we have time?
It's cuffing season. Are you cuffing or being a good boy? A little bit of both.
A little bit of both?
A little bit of both.
You can't be a little bit. So you're halfway into a relationship and halfway being a hoe?
I wouldn't
you
say.
Like this.
No.
Like one leg in and one leg
out.
Right, like.
I wouldn't say halfway. I would say there are certain people that you don't allow in your space and certain people you do.
Yeah. About energy.
Right. You know, your home, your bed is sacred as much as people will say it's not.
Right, I agree.
And letting a lot of people into your energy is, you know.
Yeah,
a lot. Mm-hmm. So I'm not gonna say that I'm like in a relationship, but I'm definitely not gonna say that I'm. There's not like five niggas a week or nothing like that. But
mm-hmm. Oh, there should be.
Right. There was.
That was a pretty solid number. Yeah.
Once you know better, you do better.
I didn't come up with that number. I don't know.
Yeah, wild.
Okay, so my question is your DM popping?
Is it?
Constantly.
Wow.
Yeah, like,
have you seen his recent content?
No, wait. First of all,
I didn't get to. He was passing that around, guys, by
first
the way.
Of all,
he was passing around
his cheeks
recent,
and lace. I don't know what happened.
Why he got exiled from Instagram.
I
want to see the picture.
Like,
Can I see it?
I can show the audience, doesn't have to see. I can show you right after this, but
After these messages.
I'm mad I got deleted from Instagram. Like,
wait, was it really spicy?
It was cheeks and lace.
It wasn't really that bad.
It was cheeky lakes? No, cheeky laces?
There are cheeks and there is a lot of lace. Uh-huh. No, I'm not going to say this.
It was a lot of lace.
It was a little bit of lace.
No disrespect. It was like one of those screenshot pictures for like, If it's somebody's OnlyFans account, like,
oh my God,
don't catch me and my man.
Wow.
No offense, because you know,
but very racy.
But the thing is, in 2020, right? Yeah, 2020, you have to like be more like just open minded to certain things. Like, you should be able to go on Instagram and see somebody eating ass. Like, you really should be.
Oh no!
I'm sorry.
I stopped using Tumblr because Tumblr just gets me horny and I just go straight to
There's nothing on Tumblr. That. Twitter has everything.
Yeah, like, Twitter is like crazy.
I go to Twitter.
Your future husband is probably up there showing the cheeks.
Listen,
I saw him show his. You know what?
As I would like
I go,
to
I go
be.
To Twitter and I watch my favorite fisting videos.
Well, privately.
No. I swear to God. Twitter has the best fisting videos. Cum shots.
So you like fisting?
Wow. Yeah, I love fisting. Like,
you like getting fisted?
Not getting fisted. I like doing it to people.
Well, let's save that for our next game.
Oh, yeah. That's next episode.
Loso, do you
that's the next much? Episode.
I can't.
Craziest and most horrible Valentine's sex tale.
Have I had sex?
I'm not gonna lie, I've only had like two Valentines in my life.
Did you have sex on Valentine's Day?
Oh, there was 1 year, yeah. Yeah.
How was it? That didn't sound like it was amazing.
We need details.
Yeah, right. We need details.
Why was it amazing? Because you loved him?
Did you suck the dick before you went in his house? You know, you're being proper and stuff.
Right, did you like, how did it go?
Nigga.
That sounds like something.
No. We're gonna have this conversation later. Alrighty, let me close out the game with mine.
We want the meat, none of the bones.
I hope mine's not no stupid shit. Am I a pleaser? I am totally a pleaser.
Are you?
I'm totes pleasure. Totes pleasure. I like to please. It pleases me to see you pleased. So I'm gonna keep pleasing. So I don't bottom, right? But I've messed around with tops. So I'm like, okay, I get it. This is not gonna go where it needs to go, but we could do a foreplay.
You can do so much. You can do a lot.
We can do a lot. Like a little this, a little bit of that.
Yeah.
But I can't suck dick like I used to. I guess, I don't know, when I was younger, I was a better dick sucker. Now I can't suck dick for shit, like small dicks. So 13-inch dicks, I feel so bad for guys who have dicks that big. I'm like, who can please that but somebody who gets fisted or footed? We'll get into footing later.
But what happened? What changed from you being younger? Did the jaw grow?
I think my gag reflex got worse. Like when I brush my teeth, I'm like, look. So,
like the ultimate dick sucking age is 16, for real.
16?
You know, yes, it is. Let me tell you something. I learned how to suck dick at 14.
I think the first couple of years.
And at 16, I was an expert.
The first couple of years of being gay in general, mm-hmm. I think you're like going crazy with it. You know what I mean?
That's
so
fair.
I feel like you're more sexually whatever.
I can't.
A 13, like, I'm sorry. I'm going to tell you right now, this is not going. This is not going anywhere, buddy. Like, could barely fit a fucking. Something like this in my mouth.
Well, there's like
crazy.
A new wave of like everyone being obsessed with how big.
Oh my God. We're size like, is a huge thing nowadays.
To be honest, when we were like really young and like
no one cared about size.
No one cared. No, it wasn't even a topic we mm-hmm. even talked
it was
about.
Never,
we were so happy.
We used
happy.
To shame size queens back in the day.
Yeah.
Now everyone's like, I want to ride a 2X.
It's got to be more than 10 inches. I'm like, who cares about that?
No, some bitches like, I don't even want to see your face. Let me see your dick.
Exactly. It's so...
And so it's like, wow, we're gay, but sheesh.
We were so concerned about having just an opportunity to be gay and find other gay people.
Right, right. Now
we
it's
weren't
very,
even thinking about
it. Now it's very shallow and very much like how much money you have or how big is your dick.
Yeah, I'm like, the fuck? Who cares about
that shit? I think we shouldn't be really focusing on dick size. We think we should be focusing on the nut that comes after. That should be the
main
thing.
Chad needs to really be
Chad needs to be on that show a lot.
Let me tell you something. Let me tell you.
I hate nut. I really do.
My favorite. My favorite thing about nuts.
But you said you were a pleaser.
But I'm not gonna
let you go.
I'm not gonna let you please all over my face.
Wait. Calm down.
You can please yourself like over there. Either. On my chest,
like
on my stomach,
either.
On my leg.
I guess I'm a little OCD with it. Like, I don't even like my own nut.
Right.
Like,
okay.
Or somebody, like, when somebody.
Oh my God.
Where am I going to nut at? What do you mean where you going?
Right here.
Over there.
Give me a hug.
Really?
And then I know people that like to swallow nut, put it in their
I don't feet. Mind that. I don't swallow, but
ever since I've been 16, I've been had this thing, like, I just love nut all over my face.
You and the 16.
Like,
we gotta talk after this episode. Alrighty, well, that wraps up this game of the Coochie Box.
Today's show is going to be crazy, as you can see. Later, we're gonna hear Trent Cruz's crazy ass sex tale. We're going to get all in your business on the behind the scenes romance
all up in
of you and you know who.
I can.
Yep, that happened. We'll be right back.
That happens.
Keep stumbling, keep fumbling. Hey, my circle stays small as hell. My homies, I know them well. Don't take it personal, that ain't my style. For me to warm up, it's gonna take a while. Care for some things, gotta play it out.
Keep a small circle.
I circle. Yeah.
We're here with Trent Cruz. And we're all just basically gonna ask him a quick question about himself. Is that okay with you?
Sure, let's do it.
Okay, let's start with Julian.
When was the last time you got nutted on? Since we were just talking about it, I'm sorry.
So tell me what that nut do.
Not in your mouth, like on your body.
My body?
When was the last time you got nutted on?
Oh my God, it shouldn't be that long. Like,
right, he's thinking about it, he's like,
I'm a changed man. I'm growing and maturing.
Listen, it's 2020. If y'all slow down on sucking dicks in 2020, that's a problem.
I really am. Okay, me too. I'm a changed man.
I really
like somebody now, so I'm very like, when I like somebody, I'm very like, I'm away from the whole phase. Mm-hmm.
Continue.
You know?
I want to say like maybe 2 or 3 weeks ago.
Okay, not too bad. Where was it, if I may ask?
They were...
What are they nut on?
Oh, like on my chest. They were like riding.
So it created like a little puddle, you know, like the little nut puddle right there?
Oh my God, nut puddle. It shouldn't be no puddle. It should be shooting all over your head.
I mean, everybody.
Oh my God.
I'm sorry. Like,
it's, wow, why you're meant for this show.
It's a topic. It's a topic.
Why do you have to have it there?
It's a topic.
What is your question for Trent?
When was your last time taking multiple dicks, but. Fucking multiple people at once in the same room on the same day on the same night.
Wow.
I'm not gonna go further.
That was such my old life, and I'm not trying to be funny. Like I used to, babe.
Trent,
shut
up.
I used to go in. Like I have grown and matured. No, seriously, I have done a lot. I would say like summer of last year.
So that's last year.
Yeah.
Wow.
Seriously. What is
that? I don't really believe him, but wow.
I swear to God.
I'll take your word for it.
I swear.
So my question, I hear you and Julius saying, yeah, I remember. So what happened between you and Julius?
What? Wait, no.
We have a lot.
No.
Yeah, have you guys been in the same, not together,
we
but
have
you
of,
guys been
we
in
have a lot
same
of the same
room?
We have similar. We have a lot of the same friends.
So he may be in the room, but he's not particularly partaking.
We have a lot of
him.
Same friends.
So you guys were in the same room.
No,
we were in the same city, and we have friends that
we're in the same city.
Do the same things
same
as
room.
Us.
We had a good time.
There was nothing, guys. Come on, don't start no rumor.
Like I said last summer.
You said, "Oh, wait." Like I said last summer.
Right, that was last summer.
Fire Island.
I don't do Fire Island.
I got raped in Fire Island.
It was Washington, D.C.
It was D.C.
But anyway,
it was last summer.
So now we're going to get into a fun portion of the episode where we are going to play a nice game called Yup, That Happened. And we're going to start off with me basically stating something that's happened. Mm-hmm. And if you guys believe any of us have been through it, you say how many of us out of the four have done it. So let's, for instance, say falling on their face, 3 out of 4 or 2 out of 4. So and then whoever gets them all right and... You know,
win the game.
You win a subway fare back home. Okay.
Oh my God.
$275.
You know what? $550. Hey. Give you a round trip.
Always get a round trip.
All right, guys. So the first one is, ever gotten stood up on Valentine's Day? I feel like we're all fly, so I feel like none of us have gotten stood up on Valentine's Day. You?
Yeah, I feel the exact same way. We all
zero?
Yeah.
Zero. You agree
none
to? Zero. All right. So we all believe none of us got stood up. Safe answer.
That's correct. Everybody got it right.
All right, the next one is, stood someone else up for Valentine's. I feel like one or two of us have done that. I'm gonna say 2 out of 4.
I'm gonna say one person.
I'm gonna say 1 out of 4, yeah.
Y'all think it's me? Thank you. I'm never that rude.
Has everyone said no?
Oh. No, I said, what did I say?
Yeah, there we go. Oh, there we go.
So did you stand someone up?
Hosting gig gone. Mm-hmm. What happened?
So did you stand someone up?
I've never stood anyone up, guys.
Okay, are you sure?
So why
so you lost?
The idea that you did.
I said 2 out of 4 of us. I thought maybe one of y'all stood someone up.
No. We're classy, not trashy.
Oh, okay.
So the next one is, currently have a sugar daddy.
I'm not trying to be shady, but I feel like maybe 2 of y'all do.
I feel like Carlos does.
Oh my God.
So I'm gonna say 2 out of 4.
I would say none out of 4.
Trent, you're so nice.
I don't think
think none of us have sugar
daddy? I don't.
You're a fool. No, I'm kidding.
I really think I'm a fool.
He's still gagging.
Listen, I don't have a sugar daddy. I've never
I'm
had
taking
a
applications
daddy,
though.
But I'm at the age of 30 where, you know what, if a dude wanna come on by and be a sugar daddy for me, then why not? But I've never done that.
Wait, so it took you to get to 30 to figure that out.
Yeah, right. Now that all the girls
now they don't want our old
asses.
You think they want our old asses? They want
but first of all, I don't know.
Like a dry prune.
Like we're dried as prunes.
And I ain't dry.
Experience prunes, but prunes.
I'm telling you.
One
person. I said 0.
I say 1.
Alright, 0.
Oh, Trent's winning the fucking game.
Right?
Damn, Chad, you really in real life gonna have a sugar daddy? Wow!
The next question is, never been on a trip with a lover?
Oh, I've been on trips with lovers. Those are the best trips to take.
I think 3 out of 4.
I think 3 out of 4.
I think So I most of us four. Have, I think have all been. Four. Yeah, I think all four of
all
us
four.
Have.
All four. All four. We all say all four. I'm so fucking devastated.
It's me. I'm one of the yes.
I say yes, too.
I'm yes. I went.
So like, y'all never went on a trip with lovers?
I did. I say yes.
Never. So then it's miscount.
Has any of us ever done drag?
I have been doing this drag impersonation.
Wait. Answer the question first. Wait. One, two,
oh,
three,
okay,
four.
Okay.
That's fucking loud.
Okay, I think that I did.
I would say.
I say one out of four.
Two out of four. I would say loud. Two out of four.
Wait, no way. I say two out of four.
I'm saying two out of four.
I'm saying two out of four, too.
I'm saying two out of four.
Sir?
Wait, let him guess.
I don't give a fuck. I'm saying me. I did drag.
I don't give a fuck. I'm giving my number. My number is me. I don't give a fuck.
I say two out of four.
I say two out of four.
Okay, Loso only one got it right. One.
What? Loso got the point.
Oh my god, so wait, so you're the only person that's ever done drag here?
Yeah, 10 years ago.
Oh my god.
10 years ago. 10.
It still don't matter. You still were wearing a thong?
No, not a thong.
What were you wearing then?
I'll pull up a video so you can see.
Oh.
Is it, all right, is it Loso, do you want to
go? It would either be a drag or be an escort.
Or a drag escort. That's genius.
Oh, okay, wow, this one is a little invasive. Who nuts a lot?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Are we gonna elaborate or are we just
gonna? No, just numbers.
All right, not gonna elaborate.
Just numbers.
My answer was huh?
Because I've been going, you know what? I'm just gonna shut up. I really feel like three out of four of us nut a lot in here.
I would say
I feel like one out of four of us nut a lot.
Two out of four.
I would say two out of four.
I'm gonna say one out of four.
Trent and Loso got it right.
What?
Wait, so who's the two? I know I'm one, but who's the other two?
Like, is there anything sexual in the subway or train?
Absolutely.
I'm gonna
I feel like there's some freaky ass bitches in here, so I'm gonna say
four out of four.
That's a four out of four.
Four
stop.
Out of four.
Mm-hmm.
Four out of four. Everyone's done it.
Has to be a four out of four. That's a usual thing yeah. for everyone.
Gay, straight, black, yeah. white.
Yeah.
We all right? All right. We all got so we're all whores, clearly. Yeah. So.
Used to be.
I'm gonna use that line.
Used to be.
So right, what did you guys do in the subway?
I jerked off one night.
On the subway?
Train.
Damn, you couldn't wait?
Top from 59
you said you jerked off?
You couldn't wait?
You thought I had sex on the train?
I didn't. I've
never done that.
With who? Why wouldn't
you? I just jerked off one random night after the club, but I was like 18.
By yourself? Oh my god, that long?
Yeah, the train was
what is happening with you? Like, I really thought you were more freakier than this. Like, I really did.
Okay, let's hear your subway story.
I mean, my subway stories ain't much. I've never fucked in the train before, but I've always wanted to fuck in the train after the club when I'm drunk, but...
What was your
but I usually
story?
Take an Uber home after the club. I couldn't take it.
So,
but I mean, I've sucked dick in the train before. Okay.
It's not normal.
I've always
things.
Wanted to eat ass in the train.
Have you ate ass in the train?
I want to.
Yeah, it's difficult to do that.
No, it's not
hard.
I don't think it's that
harder.
Difficult.
Not with 59
G. If you go on the 6th train, the 6th
right,
train.
Right, but you gotta go in between the carts.
You gotta
go 9 minutes. Go
but that's it. But that's
you got
it, though,
99
right?
minutes.
When you
you
add,
got, you got 8 minutes. You got 7 minutes.
When you add, listen.
From
when you add danger,
to 125, you got 9 minutes.
That's the whole point about fucking in a train. Like you have to add danger to it. If you don't add danger to it, it's still gonna be like, okay, we're just eating ass.
Change
at home.
Of danger.
Yeah, like you have to eat the ass and suck the dick in a train. Like, okay, somebody's probably gonna walk in next. Like,
right.
You have to have that in your mind.
That's
like,
what makes it.
That's what makes. Yeah, it makes you excited.
No.
Like sucking dick in between the train cars. Like you're scared that you're gonna fall off.
Very right. So adrenaline. It's like, am I gonna die or am I gonna suck this dick? Like,
I guess I just give
on?
Off whole vibes sometimes, but I'm not really, like, I don't do none of that weird shit. Like,
oh my god.
No. But that's fair,
I
you know.
Don't.
But imagine
like,
to die. Like,
he made
the
last
thing.
Yeah, I did, but
the
I
last
did
thing
not,
I did before died
but
it, was
but if,
dick
but if you're gonna die, wouldn't you wanna die knowing that?
Fuck, I'm gonna be dead sucking dick.
That's
exactly. So might as well. Like,
no, I might be in hell or heaven sucking dick.
But what's the problem?
I'm not doing it on the fucking train. I guess it's just different. I always try to have like that proper gay guy. I mean, don't get me wrong. When I'm with my friends.
I thought I was the proper
when
one.
When I'm with my friends, it doesn't matter like in a club environment. But I've always, since I do what I do for a living, I never wanted to God forbid they catch me. Like, oh my God, this person is exactly. Just sucking dick on a train or like.
But what's wrong with that?
It's a lot
that's your
wrong
makeup.
With that. A lot wrong with that. You know who would have nothing wrong with that? Boys who are okay with showing their buttholes and their dicks on like OnlyFans or the
sexual
websites. I don't even have a fucking Grindr or a Jack.
Oh, you
since
don't?
I was 18, no. Ever since I got catfished, I never had none of them.
She's classy.
Oh, I'm getting so much love today for not being a hoe.
Oh my God.
Thank I don't you. Even know you anymore.
Right.
I mean, if they fake being a hoe, then I'm a fake. To be cool, you have a hoe. Sure, fuck it.
Next up.
Down to fuck.
Who is down to fuck?
Four out of four.
No,
I'm a yes, though, but.
No, because you don't know who you DT.
Loso is lying. Loso, if you four put no in this question, you're lying.
It's because it's stop. Okay,
down to fuck anybody here. Just down to fuck,
period. Down to fuck. No, you don't know who it changes.
It's who you want
it
to be.
It's just whoever you want it to be. Like,
so I'm gonna say no. I'm gonna say three out of four.
But okay,
cut
the cameras. So the real question.
Dead ass. Like,
I told you I was right. Three out of four. Yes, but it's four out of four.
No, because we're saying be honest.
No, that's because you lied.
I didn't lie. I said the truth. I said no because I don't know who I'm fucking. I didn't know.
You thought too much into it.
So wait, you have to know who you're fucking to fuck them.
I mean, do you?
For the most part, no. You know what?
Okay. I
think that's a very triggered question.
It yes, it's a triggered clear. Question.
It's
like,
not clear. It's not clear.
And who is ready for a relationship?
I'm gonna say so ready for a relationship.
I'm gonna say all four of us could be ready for a relationship.
Hell nah. I'm two of us are ready for a relationship.
I'd say four to four.
Two out of four.
Mm-hmm. Oh, two is right.
Damn, because you know only me and Taz, right?
And for real, I feel like me and him, like, yeah.
I said two.
That's what nobody knows
first
about
First of all,
me.
You were just talking about semen. You know what?
But just,
and then you're ready for a
relationship. So.
Yeah, but you can be a hoe in a relationship. People don't get that.
And it's not being a hoe.
No, listen. Yeah, you can be a hoe with your man.
You can be a hoe with
your
man.
Oh, with your man together.
No, that was somebody else.
Let me tell you something. If you have a man that don't make you know that you're a nasty-ass fucking slut, when the time is right, you have an issue.
If you don't spit in your mouth, then it ain't right.
First of all, you spit all over me while fucking. So it's like,
not me. He didn't mean me.
What is happening?
I like spit.
A fun fact about me, I've been in relationships for the past 10 years.
Okay.
Relationship.
And it's tiring.
For the past year, I've been single. And it's the first year in 10 years that I could say that I had a whole phase. That don't mean I'm fucking everybody, but I'm flirting with whoever wanna fucking flirt with me. But you know, now to the next one, I feel like I am ready for a relationship and I want one because I'm such a lover.
Because when I was saying it,
and Julius last year was like, let's get in a relationship.
Julius, if you get back in a relationship,
Libra.
But it was because I was.
You need it. You need it.
I needed that 1 year of being a hoe.
He left me whole and dry. Get it? High and dry.
I'm a verse. How many people here do we think?
Two out of four.
I feel like all three of you guys are verse. I feel like all four of us is verse, and some people just verse when they feel like it and just call it topic.
Yeah, and lie and say that they don't.
Are you kidding me?
I'm just saying. Bloop. This is
three out of four.
I'm saying
two out of four.
The answer is three out of four, but I'm not lying.
I wouldn't lie. Trust me, you wouldn't want to get in this. Trust me.
He might actually like all the shit that comes out of there.
Right.
He's like asking me like if I know, like if I back it up.
You don't want to go in there.
My God. I want to ask the question that the viewers are thinking, like everybody back home are thinking right now.
Yes.
So how does Jonathan's ass taste?
I gotta go.
That's a good one. We want to know.
Like, I want to know.
The public deserves an answer.
I want to know.
That was a risque question.
I don't even know how to answer that.
Morris, I can't just chill out for a bit. I actually have a real job.
It really will be like a window of exploration for someone to really analyze themselves and come up with better solutions to the things that they're dealing with in their life.
So Morris is now in a place where he has that personal confidence. He loves himself. He's not questioning himself. And he's gotten past his past issues.
I want people to take away a sense of self-care as far as when it comes to protecting yourself mentally and emotionally. A little mom.
I will give you a very
ambiguous answer.
Polished answer. Mm-hmm. Okay. You see Jonathan takes very good care of himself. He's very clean, he's very polished, he's very put together. He always makes sure that he is presentable.
Mm-hmm. So in other words, it tastes like cucumber water.
I will say that he always makes sure that he is presentable.
Okay. I like your political answer. Yeah. Good.
I like that. Good. How have things been since Love & Hip Hop? Because I know that they made you look crazy. Like, you know, like,
I mean,
like,
that's such a double-edged
question. I don't know what he was doing on Grindr.
How have things been?
He probably really was on Grindr.
So how have things
been? When I saw the episode, I'm like, oh my God, he probably really was, though.
He was like, oh, he's in the area.
I'm like, oh my God, he's right next to me.
How has things been since Love & Hip Hop? Yeah. God, I don't even think we have enough time for that answer.
But have you been working? How's everything been going? Like, have you gotten bad backlash?
To be honest, things have been going really, really bad.
Really?
Oh, yeah, and people are like shocked when I say that.
That was a bad move?
I wouldn't say it was a bad move. I just went on the show. Blinded and naively. I wish I was the person I was when I was 20.
Okay. Right.
I was mean. I was nasty, I had a mouth on me, I was egotistical, you couldn't tell me shit. But to be honest with you, and this is no shade to any other guys on the show, but they don't really have a lot of talented gay men of color on the show.
Right.
And I'm not trying to be funny, but I know the anointing that God gave me.
Right, right, right.
So I knew that with my talent, I didn't need to go on and act crazy and curse and you know, and be that character.
You didn't need
Unfortunately,
to do all that.
That's what they wanted.
Right, right.
And so, had they caught me at an early time in my career when I, you know, I got my first deal. People don't know I got my first deal when I was 18. You know, I got dropped from Atlantic when I was 21 for being gay. I got dropped by Interscope when I was 24 for being gay. I got dropped from Sony when I was 27 for being gay. So when Love & Hip Hop came, I had already been in the industry for 10 years.
You can't sue for that, for getting fired, for getting...
Because they never really say it's for him being gay. He just knows make up some bullshit.
The point is, they say, we don't know how to sell you. We don't know how to market you.
We don't know how to market you.
Because you're gay.
We don't know how to brand you, which is AKA, we don't know what to do with a gay talent. So now, mind you,
I gave person with talent.
We're going to get to that in about 5 minutes. I'm coming
right.
I'm coming, hold on. I'm getting there, don't worry. So long story short, by the time I filmed the show, I had been in the industry since I was 17 or 18 years old. And back in the day, we got training, we got PR classes, we had to behave a certain way, look a certain way, talk a certain way. So I hate to say this, but I came on the show too polished.
Right.
A lot of the characters on the show come off the street.
Right.
So they loud, they hood rat. I came on the show.
Marketable.
10 years in the game. So I was like, okay, I'm ready to start. I was too.
Yeah.
I was too ready. I was
too ready.
I was too commercial.
And too polished and too humble.
Yeah. Because I've been through so much in my career. So when they would say to me, oh, this girl says so and so about you, and she says this and the third, I was like, okay, well, I'm sorry to feel that way. Yeah. I don't
know. Like, oh, no. They want you to throw a shoe, they want you to throw a fit.
And like for me as the first gay black artist for Love & Hip Hop New York, I didn't want to go on there and embarrass, not to be funny, but embarrass y'all.
Embarrass us.
Because
and
I felt like I had the gay black male on my shoulder. Mm-hmm. Like I'm not going to go on TV
and disappoint us
and call black women bitches and hoes and sluts, especially when I don't even know them.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? So had they caught me, like no shade, but had they caught me someone like a Cardi B who was literally off the street.
Right.
I would have had a mouth and a bitch and a guess what the fuck you.
Right.
But I went through that and I burned bridges doing that. And I like, you know what I mean? Like when I was in my early 20s, like I recorded with Britney Spears. I was there when Beyonce recorded 1+1. I've been in the studio with Rihanna. I've done so much in my career. So I was just, I don't know how to turn up and act a fool. I only know how to be camera ready and polished.
But that's because the difference between you and a lot of different people is that you know your worth.
Right.
And a lot of people don't. And don't feel bad about
it. They're still trying to find their worth. They're trying to
value that shit in this industry, because when you know your worth, you can get anything you want. Right.
So I'm not going to say that. I'll say it's been bad, but only because there's been so many opportunities that came after that but they don't know what to do with me because you said it best. Like back when I was 20 and 21 and, you know, like I basically got dropped from Atlantic because Chris Brown blew up and they were like, we don't need another light-skinned black boy who looks like you and sounds like you.
Right.
So a lot of black boys at that time when Chris came out got dropped. So we were all looking for a label. Yeah. Then I went to Atlantic and I ended up like opening for Chris Brown on a bunch of tours. I lived with Trey Songz and recorded, but, like there were a bunch of stuff, but they didn't know what to do.
But because, throughout everything, you have to realize that you still didn't give up, which is the main thing.
Right.
Yeah, it's been hard not to because now I'm not gay enough.
Okay.
I've spent the first, I
right,
spent,
now you're not gay enough. Before spent, you were so gay, you know, now you're not gay enough.
That no, back then, us growing up, we were so out and open and, mm-hmm. and we got shunned. So we, as
closed
years
up.
Went by,
we pulled it. Yeah.
And now exactly. the new girls are like,
but now the new girls are all over the place throwing shit. And that's now marketable. They would have called any one of us when we were 17, 18. We would have all been on a motherfucking show. Because back then they used to smack bitches left and right. We don't give no fucks given.
There's been a lot of opportunities for me.
I feel like we're grown. We don't got to be smacking and throwing shit at people. Like,
and I can't, obviously I'm not allowed to say like networks and shows. But there's been a lot of big shows about our lifestyle.
We all know what that is.
And they're the wrong.
And they told me that I didn't fit the queer.
I wish I could say some names. Sorry, I wish I could say some names because I don't like. I, that's another thing. Every show that has a gay person in it, it's either
a woman.
It's either a whole boy with lashes on, a full makeup, and the extra gay.
And the wig is never right.
Not that there's nothing wrong with them. It's just that it's
the wig
extra.
Is never right.
The wig is never right.
And
you know. My biggest thing now, so you asked me like, what's next? Obviously, I'm still recording. I have a new album coming out right before summer. It's called Poppy. It's my first EP in like 3 or 4 years. So I'm excited about that. I have a bunch of shows coming up, SOBs and third, whatever. But my new agenda, and this is gonna get a lot of flack, but my new agenda is to try to bring back the masculinity of what a gay black male is. Because unfortunately, TV and social media were only seen as drag queens and overly feminine men, and which I don't have a problem with that. And again, our generation, we were early 20s, we didn't get a chance to see that.
Yeah, like,
my only concern is that that's the only face.
Yeah.
So I want to bring back the masculine gay black man who doesn't need to turn up and turn out and act the fool just to be seen and heard.
They never saw Noah's Ark when they had all the mixture of different gays in one thing.
But that was so groundbreaking, it was too much.
So good.
I've never watched it.
Well, thank you for your answer, guys. You're a little round of applause for Trent. Well, you know what? You'll get through it. You're going to do excellent.
It's coming. Don't worry.
I am B-Hawk Snipes, and we're here at the Airlist Awards. Get into it.
Welcome back. We have Trent Cruz with us for our Valentine's special, and now let's hear his sex tale. Remember, I want details.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I want description.
Come details.
I want everything that you will give the person that you give.
I want a minute by minute run through from entering the door, if there was even a door.
Okay.
To exiting,
but
if there
like
was even any exiting.
Long.
I'm gonna tell you a story that I promised I would never tell. Yeah. I'm actually gonna
you
tell.
Promised you wouldn't
Let
tell
me
anybody.
Get
I'm gonna tell because
I knew that y'all did something.
There you go.
You're gonna
there
cut
go.
This
it's
rumor out.
Out
real quick.
Because I think this is no, honestly, I think this is.
Oh God, if my ex is watching.
I think this is one of the. I think this is one of the rumors that got around about me that really like. Tarnish my brand.
Mm-hmm.
So I used to live in Jersey, so you know this was like 1,000 years ago when I first moved to New York City. And I guess, apparently, I used to like hook up with this guy who lived like whatever across the way.
Mm-hmm.
And apparently, we had hooked up one day, and he apparently told mad people that when he came to see me, my face smelled like I already had sex.
Your face?
Smell.
Oh, I get it.
Like,
it.
Like your mouth?
No, your face. Like when somebody nuts on your face and like, it smells after?
No.
It does smell after.
Chad is officially the third cat number in this like, shit because
it does smell bad after.
Like, were you rubbing your face in someone's genitalia? Like, just like,
yo, that shot got me drunk.
Well, you know, when someone sits on your face, you know, there's a little bit of a sense.
That's
so
what I'm saying.
Someone sat on your face.
So this certain person claimed.
He said your mouth smell like ass.
I'm not saying that.
Hey.
All I'm saying is that.
How you doing?
All I'm saying is that this certain person said that I smell like I already had sex.
Mm-hmm. Did you?
I'll get.
Oh. Now, does my hand smell like sex?
It smells like balls.
Mine smells
like coconut. Balls. I did
I'm
scratch
sorry,
balls
we so rude to his story right
okay,
now.
Okay, I'm so sorry.
Man, rude. You see?
All I heard was my face smells like ass.
How my balls smell?
Okay, so he said that your face smelled like sex.
Yes. Oh. So. Years later, I kept hearing this story over and over. Oh, you get around. Mm-hmm. Somebody said you do this and the third. Oh, I keep hearing. And it was like, and I'm like, where did this story keep coming from? I've heard it from people who don't know me. I've heard it from people that I've tried to date. Like this one particular story went around everywhere. Mm-hmm. Years later, 7-8 years later, I come to find out who this person was. I put 2 and 2 together. I was actually sitting down with a friend. And his friend came, we were at like Taco Tuesday. Mm-hmm. His friend came like, oh, aren't you the guy that, you know, smelled like, and I was like, where?
7 years later.
I'm like, where is this coming from?
That friend needs to
right,
be smacked.
They need to let go of that, because 7 years is, y'all dragging it.
But let me
at
finish.
At that point, I would have been like, yes,
yeah.
Yes,
let me finish.
I smell like sex.
So this person who I didn't know was mm-hmm. like, oh, this person said it. And I was like, oh, I was like, he's absolutely 100% right. That did happen.
Okay.
But.
So it did smell like ass.
Wait, so but, you had sex.
But
so
let me finish. So let me finish.
So,
so what happened was, I probably had already had sex and then called him over and had sex with him. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But this is my problem when people start rumors.
That's disgusting.
This, I was a young lad.
Live his life. Care. Sometimes you have, sometimes
let
you
me
have
finish.
Some evolving
I don't even three something, none of that.
Let me finish. This is my problem when people tell a story. They like to tell one side of the story mm-hmm. and not the whole story. So you run and tell, oh, yo, I went to go after the train. He smelled mm-hmm. like he was eating ass. But what you didn't say,
I knew it.
But what you didn't say is that you let me smash still.
Ooh. I mean, he was horny. Yes. He was cleaning his ass. Like,
and you let me smash multiple times after that.
After, okay.
Did he still kiss you and all that
of
stuff?
Course.
He trifling.
Of course. When I found out who it was,
I mean, you can't
really?
Complain about someone's
who was
face,
it? Sherry, fuck. Who was it?
We do know, I know him?
We know this person.
Oh, you telling me.
That's off camera. That's off camera.
No, you telling me.
That's off camera.
Wait.
Anyways.
Trent?
It's off camera.
Look at me.
Anyway, it's
person?
Off camera.
We all know.
Anyway, the problem to me, the whole point of the whole point of the story is that we all have rumors and things about each other, but tell the whole story.
Right.
Don't tell half the story. Don't say, oh, Trent is a hoe because he smelled like he was having sex.
Yeah.
Say, I still let that nigga fuck me.
Right. Mm. After I smelled
after
that.
But I've never heard
well,
that.
Well, maybe he smelled ass after.
So like, it's like at the end of the day, it's like,
get there.
It's like, right. Aren't you just as bad?
Yeah.
Right.
Aren't you just as much of a
hoe? I'm the devil. You're the
I guess
advocate.
We both smell like
first
ass
of
together.
All, he let you smash, but
it's still
wrong like, with him saying his he smelled like. So what?
Yeah.
I let you smash. So what?
Right.
It still stunk.
Just to let you know,
I still hate it, but it stunk.
Just to let you know, I've never heard that rumor before.
I never heard that rumor. I just heard you was a hoe, but I hear that I'm a hoe and I got sugar daddy too, so it's okay.
I didn't hear the whole part per se, but I did hear you partake mm-hmm. in activities, and I'm like, oh, I'm so far.
I heard.
You know what it is? Most people,
I'm very comfortable with my sexuality.
Wait, I've never heard things.
Most people who don't.
Chad, what you heard?
Most people who don't know me. And I know this doesn't help, but actually, like, I don't drink. I've never taken a drug. I've never smoked weed. I don't.
I can't believe that. I know that.
And you know me firsthand.
Yeah, I know that.
I don't drink, you drink a shot.
I'm like, you're not going to have a drink?
I literally don't do it.
He don't need it.
I don't drink. I don't do anything. I just generally don't need it.
Right.
So I've always been very...
I've
always been aware of my sexuality.
Yeah.
And I've been aware of my sexual power.
Right.
So I've never been like ashamed of it, just because I don't necessarily talk about it.
Right.
I've never been ashamed of it. I just think everyone has a different.
So you're just a secondhand smoker, basically.
And what?
Like you say, you don't do drugs. If people smoke around you, you get a little bit something.
I mean, yeah, but you know, it's not. But you know, the point is that like I've always been very open about my. sexuality because it's like the only thing that I have. Like I don't.
Okay, wait. Like I don't want to steer off from your sex tale, so keep telling me what happened.
That's just one of the stories.
That's just one of the stories.
Right.
He just wanted
the
more.
Point
so
is,
he just went to your house and got married.
And it's been rumors.
No. Let me the tell point. You what sex. Let me bring it back. I'm the original host.
Oh,
in this
Lord.
Show.
Here we go.
When you share a sex tale, I want to know. Change that one. I don't want that one.
Yeah.
I want to know. You walked in. You put his dick in your mouth. He put his dick in your mouth. He nut. That's what the show is about. A
he
sex
nut,
tale
then
you,
then he spit a nut in your face.
Share a sex tale with
not
me.
A sex rumor.
And none of us are gonna interrupt you. But share it from beginning to end. The most nastiest shit you've done. Whether it was
nope.
Jonathan
we're not gonna go the most nastiest.
No, we're not gonna
it
do
gets
that.
Really nasty.
I want the most nastiest one.
No.
I think that's a little
juicy.
Too
give me the
juicy. Personal.
Yeah,
I think
too
that's
personal.
A little too personal. I'm
making it fun.
We're not talking. Nope.
So that you don't want to.
Have you ever done park sex before?
I've.
Because you live close enough to Harlem.
I've had sex.
Park sex is
public.
Just so.
I've had park sex.
It's
I
just
must be
so.
Boring.
But yeah, when I was like a kid.
All right, guys. Well, this was a very, 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 very. This was a very, very interesting Thanksgiving edition.
Thanksgiving.
Where are you?
That shot of 1800.
I'm not bad. I don't know what happened after that shot.
Because y'all drank. You see,
I'm dyslexic.
You see, I tasted
it.
They drank it. You see the difference?
I definitely drank it.
Oh my god, you don't drink, and then you just said you don't drink.
I tasted it.
A whole shot. I'm hot. Go ahead. Let's
you said you just put your tip in on it. That's it.
All right. Well, guys, thank you so much. Thank you, Chad. Thank you, Trent.
Thank you so much.
And of course, the lovely Loso.
Hey.
Just in case you didn't know, so.
Hey, y'all already know if you're gonna chill with a dude and another one right after, clean your motherfucking body.
Yeah.
Clean your face. Don't
just a face scrub.
At least use some wipes.
A face scrub or
at
something.
At least use some wipes.
It was take one after shower. Another.
Take a whole shower.
I was young. I could do that back
then. He said I could do that. He said I could do that back
then.
That
shit is no offense. That shit is fucking nasty.
So then don't let me have sex with you then.
Hey, won't.
All right, guys, we're closing out the show.
I can't.
Yes or no? If you don't like it,
no. Close it out for us.
I can't. What if you have a sex tale that you would love to share on Sex Tales? Visit our Facebook page, facebook.com/sextalestvshow.
Thank you for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.
Hey.
Gang. Take a shower. So that rumor was going around for 7 years?
That's a long time.
That's a long time. That face must have really stunk.
Actually, I was so over it.